So we have a country that's in trouble. We're going to end the mandate on electric one day. They want to make all boats, too. I went to a boat company in South Carolina, the boat. I said, how is it? He said, it's a problem, sir. They want us to make all electric boats. These are boats that are from 16 to 35 or so feet, fishing boats, leisure boats. Beautiful company in South Carolina, beautiful. Guy's been doing it for 50 years. He sells hundreds of boats every couple of months. I mean, really fantastic guy. And they use the Mercury engines and different engines in the back, no problem. They want to take that out. They want to make it all electric. He said, the problem is the boat is so heavy, it can't float. I said, that sounds like a problem. He said, also, it can't go fast because of the weight. And they want to now have a 50 mile or a 70 mile radius. You have to go out 70 miles before you can really start the boat up. And you go out at 2 knots. That's essentially almost like 2 miles an hour. I say, how long does it take you to get out there? Many hours. And then you're allowed to go around for 10 minutes, but you have to come back because the batteries only last for a very short period of time. So I said, let me ask you a question. And he said, nobody ever asked this question. And it must be because of MIT, my relationship to MIT. Very smart. He goes, I say, what would happen if the boat sank from its weight and you're in the boat and you have this tremendously powerful battery and the battery is now underwater and there's a shark that's approximately 10 yards over there. By the way, a lot of shark attacks lately. Do you notice that? A lot of shark. I watched some guys justifying it today. Well, they weren't really that angry. They bit off the young lady's leg because of the fact that they were not hungry, but they misunderstood who she was. These people are crazy. He said, there's no problem with sharks. They just didn't really understand a young woman swimming. Now it really got decimated and other people too, a lot of shark attacks. So I said, so there's a shark 10 yards away from the boat, 10 yards or here. Do I get electrocuted? If the boat is sinking, water goes over the battery, the boat is sinking. Do I stay on top of the boat and get electrocuted? Or do I jump over by the shark and not get electrocuted? Because I will tell you, he didn't know the answer. He said, you know, nobody's ever asked me that question. I said, I think it's a good question. I think there's a lot of electric current coming through that water. But you know what I'd do if there was a shark or you get electrocuted? I'll take electrocution every single time. I'm not getting near the shark. So we're going to end that. We're going to end it for boats.
He's been watching the Electoral College map since high school and college. No one understands the race to 270 electoral votes better than Jim Heath. You can count on his fair and balanced analysis throughout election 2024. Be sure to subscribe and ring the bell. Thanks for watching the Jim Heath channel.